Greetings. As you can see, this is a very long video. I thought it would be fun to document the long and arduous process of making this dish. However, if you do not feel like watching a 40-minute video, I did put chapters in, so you can skip over certain bits. Also, to make it easier for you, the viewer, to replicate this dish, I have put the ingredients in the description. Now please, sit back and enjoy.
Are we here?
Yeah.
This is Dorothea?
Good evening.
Yes, dear. Courtney, you're gonna have the peanut butter soup with smoked duck and mashed squash. New York Matinee called it a playful but mysterious little dish. You'll love it. And then the red snapper with violets and pine nuts. I think that'll follow nicely.
Thanks, Patrick.
Hi. Today we're gonna talk of one of my favorite films, one of your favorite films, and with that, one of our favorite people, Patrick Bateman. Now, besides murdering prostitutes, he's actually quite a connoisseur of many things, including personal hygiene, lettering.
Look at that subtle off-white coloring. The tasteful thickness of it. Oh my God, it even has a watermark.
Politics?
Come on, Bryce. There are a lot more important problems than Sri Lanka to worry about.
Like what?
Well, we have to end apartheid for one, and slow down the nuclear arms race, stop terrorism, and world hunger. We have to provide food and shelter for the homeless, and oppose racial discrimination and promote civil rights, while also promoting equal rights for women. We have to encourage a return to traditional moral values. Most importantly, we have to promote general social concern and less materialism in young people.
And surprisingly of all, cuisine. And actually, he recommends us a little dish called peanut butter soup with duck and squash. Now, I think that sounds wonderful. So we're gonna make it. And as with all soups, it starts with a stock. So we're gonna make that stock, for which we will need bones.
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
Sorry for what? Our daddy tells not to be ashamed of our ducks. Actually, this is not duck. This is chicken. I had a conversation with the friendly lady at the butcher, who informed me that one, it's not duck season, so they didn't have any bones lying around for this purpose. And two, I told her about the recipe I was going to make, and she informed me that duck would be a bit too intense for this purpose. So she recommended I make chicken stock instead. So we're gonna make chicken stock, for which we are going to use these carrots, onions, garlic, some fresh thyme, parsley, oh no wait, celery, and peppercorns. And we'll get some fresh parsley from the gardens.
Now, give me that foreskin, boy.
So, now that we have collected our ingredients, we're gonna roast the chicken for a little bit, which will improve the flavor of our stock.
Looks like we're gonna have to do this in two parts.
Now, while our chicken is in the oven, it is time to prepare our aromatics.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Let's see. And of course, the garlic. That's all.
20 minutes later.
That's a good chicken.
That smells pretty good. No. What? Oh, this smells great.
Oh man. Okay, chicken for round two.
Twenty minutes later.
Thank you. that's a heavy bowl.
No. We're gonna bring it back to a boil.
Here I am skimming off the fat, which is something you want to do while making stock.
I hope all the aromatics will fit, but we'll just have to see.
Just jamming in there, man.
Just everything fits if you to push hard enough. Should you maybe cut it smaller?
Nah.
Put some carrots
like that's supposed to fast.
I mean, this will be good stock.
Yeah, I hope so.
Packed full of flavor.
It better be.
Some cloves of garlic in there. Yeah, that's right. Some peppercorns. Yeah, that's enough.
And the bouquet garni, huh?
Beautiful.
This is going to be interesting to say the least.
Six hours later.
So, the stock has been boiling or simmering for the last 7 hours. So the stock is pretty much about done now. As you can see, we lost about a liter in liquid through steam. it's 11:30 now, because we had the brilliant idea to start making stock in the afternoon. As you'll be able to see, the chicken has completely disintegrated. Like it's no longer a solid rib cage. So I'm going to pour this into containers and freeze most of it. Some of it we'll be using tomorrow for the soup. So, yeah.
3 days later.
Hey everyone. Took a bit longer than 1 day. It's later in the week now. But we're gonna continue. We're gonna make the soup. We're gonna start by turning on the oven and preheating it to 200 degrees Celsius. And we're gonna cut up the vegetables that we're gonna use for the soup. So, first thing we're gonna chop up is this pumpkin for the squash element of the dish. I have no idea how to chop a pumpkin, so I'm just going to wing it, see how it turns out. Jesus, that's pretty tough.
Quite sturdy.
Try it like this. Jesus Christ.
Nee.
Okay. So we've got the seeds in this part of the pan.
Yeah, the lower side.
Okay. Guess we're going to scoop this bit out with a spoon.
Yeah.
Okay, so we scooped out the seeds. Now we're gonna figure out how to chop this up and discard the skin, shell, I don't know what's called.
Skin, I believe.
We're going to maybe circumcise like our pumpkin.
Maybe like a melon?
Now I'm going to cut it up into little cubes that we are going to roast in the oven. So, now we are going to cover a baking sheet in foil. Okay.
That's...
Oh, that is great.
Yeah.
It's a wizard staff. Like nothing ever happened. Okay. Yeah, so we're just going to toss the pumpkin. With some salt and oil. Preheated now. And this will take about 45 minutes. So, the next part is going to be warming up our homemade stock that we made earlier this week. So, because we didn't salt the stock while making it, we're gonna have to salt it now. We're gonna use a pretty generous amount of salt for this. And of course, we'll be tasting it in a bit to see whether that is the correct amount of salt. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, as for the vegetables that we will be using, four of these. tomatoes, 2 medium onions, and a Madame Jeanette pepper, also known as adjuma pepper. I will be removing the seeds because I'm not a complete masochist. Now my fingers are covered in capsaicin oil, so the last thing I want to do is wipe my ass. Okay, so, Madame Jeanette pepper, sorry. I'm so sorry. Now we are going to remove the skin. So the stock is reaching its temperature. Now we're gonna taste if there's enough salt in it. It's nearly there. It's pretty good. Needs a bit more salt. I think that should be enough. Okay. Now we're going to put in the vegetables, which we will very gently put in there. And this will go for about 10 minutes. Almost forgot, we also have to put in 3 bay leaves. So they've been simmering for about 10 minutes now. So these we're going to scoop them out. Thank you. Smells great, by the way. And now we are going to use one of my favorite tools in the kitchen. This thing, I don't know what it's called in English, but...
It's a mixer.
Very, very careful that I don't mix boiling water. Okay. Now we are going to add the other vegetables. Thank you. To reintroduce it to the soup, which we are gonna have to do very carefully. Now we also have to add some ginger.
That should do it. Okay, so the pumpkin should be done by now.
It looks very crispy.
Definitely some with burnt ends. That's we'll discard those. Yeah, should be pretty nice.
Okay, so I actually made a little bit of a mistake here. Patrick Bateman specifically calls for mashed squash or squash puree, and instead I made roasted squash. Even though this is a mistake, yes, I do actually stand by my method, because I actually don't think it's very interesting to introduce puree or mash to a soup. I think the contrast between roasted vegetables and soup is much more interesting. So, it may not be completely movie accurate, but it is a whole lot better.
Now, we're gonna add the peanut butter. The recipe I found called for 6 heaping tablespoons of butter, but peanut butter, I'm going to judge by consistency. I think this should be a pretty creamy soup. Mm-hmm. I think we're gonna let it reduce for a bit.
Okay.
So, while the soup is reducing, we're gonna prepare the chicken duck breast. As you can see, it's a very deep red. It's absolutely beautiful. And so, what we're gonna do is, almost looks like they scored it. We're gonna score. Yeah. Weird. But we're gonna score the layer of fat. Because if we don't score the fat layer, it will contract. So we're gonna leave room for the fat to shrink by making small incisions. Now, well, apparently they gave us an example to work with. So I'm going to follow that example. And we really want to be very careful, because we want to score the fat layer, not so much the meat itself. This is also why you should use a sharp knife. Now, I like the sort of cross pattern, so we're gonna make a bit of a cross pattern here. I think this is going to turn out lovely. Now, before we're going to share the duck breast,
we should put this in the oven and preheat it so that we won't put the duck breast on a cold surface once we're done searing it. So now we're going to heat up the pan to about medium high, and while the pan is heating up, we're going to season the duck breast. So pretty generously, salt and pepper on both sides. Look at that. Thought I was being smooth. Anyways, so we're gonna sear it on the fat side. We're not gonna add any oil or butter, because the fat from this should be enough to sear it, which we are going to do, I think, now. Three minutes on this side, 30 seconds on the other side. We'll turn it. That is nice. I think that's a really good sear. Okay, 30 seconds. So I'm going to time this. Okay. Now we're going to leave it in there for about 5 minutes. Okay, the duck should be ready now. And we're going to place it. Oh, look at that gravy. We're going to place it in aluminium foil. And we're going to let it rest for about 5 minutes, so that when we cut into it, we won't have all the juices spilling out, which will be somewhat unappetizing. So we're just gonna let it rest now. So it's been about 5 minutes. The duck breast should have rested by now, looking absolutely beautiful. Very crispy still. And now I'm gonna cut it. I was thinking diagonally, so nice slices.
Actually, those slices are way too thick, but well, you know, live and learn.
I'm hoping. Yes, 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 that was very nice. It's a really nice warm fat going over my fingers right now. Absolutely delicious. Okay, so it's time for plating. And I was thinking about plating it as following. So, okay. Using a big soup ladle, I'm going to create a layer of our fabulous peanut butter soup. Then now centerpiece of our dish will be the duck, which we are going to layer like so. And that is peanut butter soup with duck and squash, according to American Psycho. So, now that we've been working at this for 2 days, I think it's time we taste it. Now, peanut soup is very nice. It's actually not as hot as I would have expected, especially with the adjuma pepper in there, but delightful, delightful heat. Now, the duck breast, of course, which is just done to perfection. And now dipped in our peanut soup. I think that's a very nice pairing, especially when followed by
a red snapper with violets and pine nuts. I think that'll follow nicely.
今日の主役はこの